Hello, morning, hi everybody. Today, listening Italian 23, The Name of the Rose, a novel by Umberto Eco. Let's do it. Umberto Eco, 1932-2016, è stato ordinario di semiotica all'Università di Bologna e presidente del Centro Internazionale di Studi Semiotici e Cognitivi dell'Università di San Marino. Tra i suoi romanzi, i bestseller mondiali Il nome della rosa, of course, e Il pendolo di Foucault. Umberto Eco, 1932-2016, nato born 1932 e morto death 2016, was professor of semiotics at Bologna University, Italy, and the president of the International Center for Semiotic and Cognitive Studies at San Marino University. Among his novels, the worldwide bestsellers The Name of the Rose and The Foucault Pendulum. Primo giorno, first day. Dove si arriva ai piedi dell'abbazia e Guglielmo dà prova di grande acume. In which the foot of the abbey is reached and William gives proof of great acumen. Era una bella mattina di fine novembre. It was a fine late November morning. Nella notte aveva nevicato un poco, ma il terreno era coperto di un velo fresco non più alto di 3 dita. During the night it had snowed a little, but the ground was covered with a fresh layer no more than 3 fingers high. Al buio, subito dopo l'audi, avevamo ascoltato la messa in un villaggio a valle. In the darkness, immediately after Lauds, we had heard mass in a village in the valley. Poi ci eravamo messi in viaggio verso le montagne. Allo spuntar del sole. Then we had set off toward the mountains at setup. Come ci inerpicavamo per il sentiero scosceso che si snodava intorno al monte, vidi l'abbazia. As we toiled up the steep path that wound around the mountain, I beheld the abbey. Non mi stupirono di essa le mura che la cingevano da ogni lato, simili ad altre che vidi in tutto il mondo cristiano, ma la mole di quello che poi appresi essere l'edificio. I was amazed not by the walls that girded it on every side, similar to others I saw in all the Christian world, but by the bulk of what I later learned was the edificium. Era questa una costruzione ottagonale che a distanza appariva come un tetragono, figura perfettissima che esprime la saldezza e l'imprendibilità della città di Dio. Nice, I love this line. I cui lati meridionali si ergevano sul pianoro dell'abbazia, mentre quelli settentrionali sembravano crescere dalle falde stesse del monte, su cui si innervavano a strapiombo. This was an octagonal construction that from a distance appeared as a tetragon, a most perfect form which expresses the steadiness and impregnability of the city of God, whose southern sides stood on the plateau of the abbey, while the northern ones seemed to grow out of the very side of the mountain, on which they innervated themselves in a sheer drop. Dico che in certi punti, dal basso, sembrava che la roccia si prolungasse verso il cielo, senza soluzione di tinte e di materia. Beautiful this. E diventasse a un certo punto mastio e torrione, opera di giganti che avessero gran familiarità e con la terra e col cielo. I say that at certain points from below it seemed that the rock extended toward the heavens, with no break in colors and matter, and at a certain point became keep and tower, work of giants who had great familiarity with both earth and sky. Tre ordini di finestre dicevano il ritmo trino della sua sopraelevazione, così che ciò che era fisicamente quadrato sulla terra era spiritualmente triangolare nel cielo. I love this line, it's absolutely amazing. It's like a picture, on your eyes. Three rows of windows bespoke the triune rhythm of its elevation, so that what was physically square on the earth was spiritually triangular in the sky. Tre ordini di finestre dicevano il ritmo trino della sua sopraelevazione, così che ciò che era fisicamente quadrato sulla terra era spiritualmente triangolare nel cielo. I wrote twice. It's okay. Three rows of windows bespoke the triune rhythm of its elevation, so that what was physically square on the earth was spiritually triangular in the sky. Allora, guys, I put a note of this triune, okay, because it's easy to be misunderstood with trine and triune. That is similar, okay, but they have a very different meaning at last, okay, even if it's pertaining a triad, something regarding three entity. Let's start with the trine, okay, trine. This word, derived from the Latin term trinus, refers to a group or set of three elements that are closely related or interconnected. It embodies the concept of a trinity, a triad or a trio, emphasizing the unity and harmony found within this specific arrangement. Essentially, trine encapsulates the idea of three entities functioning as a cohesive whole, bound together in a synergistic manner. Okay, now, on the other hand, we have a triune. Trine. This term originating from the Latin word trinus, as, well, carries a slightly different meaning. In essence, triune highlights the diversity and individuality within a trinity, emphasizing the coexistence of three distinct components. Guys, I didn't write down the translation in Italian here, okay? I will do now, okay, at the moment. Allora, let's start with trine. Incominciamo con trine. This word, questa parola, derived from the Latin term trinus. Questa parola deriva dal termine latino trinus. Refers to a group or set of three elements. Si riferisce a un gruppo di o un set, o un insieme, un set di tre elementi that are closely related or interconnected, che sono strettamente relazionati o interconnessi. As you can see again, guys, you can easily relay on the root in common that we have English with Italian. Okay, so very often you have only to change a syllable and of course the pronunciation. It embodies the concept of a trinity. Rappresenta, incorpora, because body è corpo, no? Incorporare è to embody or represent, ok? It embodies, represent the concept of a trinity, il concetto di una trinità. A triad, una triade, or a trio, o un trio. How easy to learn Italian! Emphasizing the unity and harmony, enfatizzando l'unità e l'armonia found within this specific arrangement, trovata, evidenziata con questo specifico arrangiamento, ok? Insieme, disposizione, you know. Arrangement, arrangiamento, then disposizione, formation. Essentially, essenzialmente, trine encapsulates the idea of three entities. Essenzialmente, trine incapsula, rappresenta l'idea di tre entità, functioning, che funzionano as a cohesive whole, come un insieme coesivo, cohesive, coesivo, ok, stretto, no, strettamente correlato, firmly correlated, bound together, uniti insieme, in a synergistic manner, in una maniera sinergica. How easy again is Italian? Come on, guys, please, huh? You see how similar are the terminology. On the other hand, d'altro canto, or we can say, what means canto? Canto is a sing, a song, you know, it's a chant. But that is an idiomatic sense. It's like to say on the other side, okay? Dog, you know. We have triune. Abbiamo triune, triune. This term, questo termine, or questa parola, originating from the Latin word trinus, derivante dalla parola latina trinus, as well to anche questa parola, no, anche, carries a slightly different meaning, ha un significato leggermente differente, diverso. In essence, nell'essenza, triune, highlights the diversity and individuality within a trinity. In essenza, basicamente, fondamentalmente, triune evidenzia, highlights, evidenzia la diversità e la individualità della singola, of the single trinity, ok? Emphasizing the coexistence of three distinct components. Enfatizzando, emphasizing the coexistence, la coesistenza. How difficult is Italian? Sorry if I bore, but come on, guys, really. Of three, di tre distinti componenti. Alright, guys, here we are. Thank you very much. Underlining that Umberto Eco is very complicated, guys. It's really hard also for me, Italian. But it's very, Umberto Eco is amazing, you know. He's a legend for Italian literature, also to us. At the time that he wrote down this romance, since the ambience is related to Middle Age, he received a lot of critics because unfairly, because later on it has been hugely appreciated in all over the world, and going deep in the interpretation and studying and seeking of the meanings and correlated other books or historical events, okay? He make reference also to Greek philosophy or to other ancient famous books. You know, I mean to say, to read this you must have a very good background in the philosophy and history, or see, you know, because it's not easy to understand, really, it's very difficult. But that is a beautiful and interesting challenge to enrich your culture as well, you know, and because it's really amazing. I mean to say, not for nothing. Not for nothing he received a huge success, you know what I mean, backup from expert and from other writers, I mean to say. So we have to take a bit of effort. We have to give a little of effort in researching, you know, all those notes and recall, you know, that he liked to do. Amazing. All right, guys. Thank you very much and see you next. Bye.